that's a good fish. That's a catfish, I think.
White bass.
I saw the white on it, and I thought it was a belly of a little channel or something.
Did you? One hell of a start to the day. First fish in the boat so far. Hey! I'm stoked, man. I gotta get a picture of this.
I was fumbling trying to figure out how to kill the motor.
Yeah, I couldn't kill it either. I kept pressing the starter.
Oh, yeah? Sweet! You recording this?
Yeah.
Well, guys, we started the night off right. We got a white bass in the boat. First fish in the boat. Tonight I'm out here with Levi, and we're gonna be trying to chase some spawning walleye and whatever else might be biting. So,
and white bass.
White bass, apparently. Using a flicker shad, so hopefully that little bait right there is gonna do the trick. We got worms, we got all kinds of other baits, but we're gonna try and just kind of trolling with the outboard today. We don't have a trolling motor on the boat yet, so that's kind of the game plan, man. I was just trying to get us to the spot while you were getting rigged, and I was just kind of trolling, and I got a bite. So, heck of a deal. Great start. Well, night is here, and I haven't had any bites yet. So we're gonna keep cruising the bank of this dam and hopefully get a bite soon. It's not looking too promising though. But I switched up to a different crank, so we're gonna try that and do a little cast and reel and see how we do. My only problem is casting and reeling, I'm not feeling the bottom. So that might be a little problematic. Might have to start trolling again. Well, last night's fishing trip didn't necessarily go like I thought it would. We didn't get skunked, caught a fish, got the boat on the water, got to run the motor for a really long time. So we were kind of trolling up and down the bank using the outboard since, I mean, there's no trolling motor on the boat. So it ran great, starts up just perfect with the electric start. Just press the button, vroom, starts right up. So today, what I've done so far is when we pulled the boat out last night, we found out that the blinkers and brake lights were not working on the trailer. So I got those replaced pretty quick and easy. Opted for the LED options on these. So hopefully those last a little while. I do need to figure out how to get one of these. So I don't know if you guys know what style of light this is. Drop it down in the comments if you have a link for it. I need to get the one on the other side fixed because it doesn't have a cover. The light works, it just doesn't have the cover on it. Let me see if I can show you guys. So yeah, there you go, just like that. This boat is a Voyager, if that helps anything. I just don't know what type of light to buy. And doesn't look like Voyager is in business and building boats anymore, so that's not very helpful. So other than that, a couple things that we need to do to the boat is I want to change the lower unit oil fluid and then mount my transducer. So last night we were fishing without a depth finder, no trolling motor. We were kicking it way old school because I was waiting for this little mount to come in the mail. And so I've had a depth finder. So if you guys have watched the kayak fishing videos, you would have seen that I have Garmin Striker 4. Now, I could have opted to get a bigger and better one for this boat with side imaging, the whole deal, but I figured I'd save some money, just buy a $20 mount and go from there. I don't really know if I'm gonna upgrade it or not, but I feel like just having some down scan and water temp readings and stuff like that is gonna be really helpful. So we'll start with that and see where we go. The reason I waited to change the fluid in the lower unit was to get it in the water, run it for a while, and then drain it to see if we've got any milky kind of white stuff coming out or water telling me that we've got a leak down there. So fingers crossed, we pop this thing open and it just has regular old lower unit fluid coming out. So we'll get after it here. All right, moment of truth here. It doesn't look like there's any water in here. So that's a big relief. Kind of smells a little burnt. So probably a good thing that we're doing this. I'm not really seeing any metal shavings, so that's good too. All right, well, that's draining. I'm gonna let that drain for a while and get as much of that old stuff out as we can. While that's draining, we're gonna go ahead and get this transom mounted transducer on there. And I hope I do this right. It looks like these are some self-tappers too. So they're gonna kind of bite in that metal and lock it down so I won't have to worry about putting a nut on the other side, which will be nice. Got some silicone sealant. Got this template on here to follow. Got everything we need, so hopefully this will work. I've got it lined up just right, like it says, following the instructions. So ideally this will work great. I've moved it kind of off to the side here. There's not gonna be a whole lot of interference over here, I think. So I think this would be a good spot for it. The instructions said to put a piece of tape 1 inch down on the drill bit so then you know when to stop drilling. Okay, I've never drilled a hole on a boat like this before, so this could be interesting. Makes me nervous. All right. I guess the 1 inch deal doesn't apply. This metal's so thin. All right, well, hopefully this silicone does the trick. I'm gonna put a decent amount on there. Makes me nervous, man. I know a lot of people do this, but it just makes me nervous poking holes in a boat beneath the waterline. Sweet. So the instructions on here say to drill another hole in here and route the wire through, but I'm gonna just run the wire up through this handle and over the top and over to the deal, because chances are I'll probably end up removing the transducer come duck season. I'll leave this mount here. Hopefully it'll hold up, but yeah, I don't wanna punch another hole in here for no reason. I mean, there's no purpose to it, so. I'll run this over and have it go to the depth finder, and hopefully it'll be good. I'm gonna see if I can get silicone on the backside of this steel too, just to be safe. I think this definitely needed to get drained and changed. It was black and it stinks. So got this handy dandy little tool here. We're gonna just stick in the bottom here and fill her up. All right, I got everything figured out here for the depth finder. So, like I said, I'm gonna be using my Garmin Striker 4 on this boat. No need to go above and beyond and try and figure out how to use fancy electronics. All I need to know is the depth that I'm going over. So, I've got this mounted on a little, here you go. So I got this thing mounted here. It's got a quick detach and quick attach, so that's mounted to the seat with a couple screws. This will just slide right on there and I can adjust it how I want it. So I got these two cables, one's for power, one's for the transducer. I've got the cables running down here and kind of tied them in here with the cords for the electric start, ran them underneath this seat. And then they keep going, keep going. And they come out back in here. And inside this ammo box, I've got my battery. So you guys might recognize this battery. This is the little battery I've been using for years inside my kayaks to run the depth finder and my LED lights. So there's a good look at it. 12 volt, 7.5 amp hour for 20 hours. So I haven't had any issues with this thing dying too fast while I'm on the water. I mean, I've had this thing for like 3 years now. So I've got that in a box, got the power cables hooked up, just quick connectors there, and then transducer cord. I've got it kind of balled up down here. They give you a lot. So I balled that up, put that down there, wrapped this around this handle here, so then it kind of stays over there because I run this ratchet strap up here and hook down the back side of the boat, trying to keep those separate. And then it goes to the transducer. So, moment of truth. Everything's hooked up properly. There it is. Boom. So now we got all kinds of different settings. Flasher, split frequency, waypoint map, which the waypoint map is fantastic. I use it a lot. It's kind of interesting. I guess it was running around the house, but can we zoom out and find where I went fishing? Oh. So there's no like actual maps in this thing, but like here's a lake that I used to fish a lot. Got a few waypoints marked on it, which is key for me. Being able to mark the waypoints and see my trails. Let's see here. See if I can zoom in. So yeah, here you go. Here's a good look at it. So here's a lake that I fished in my kayak. And you can see my trails and everything, which is convenient. But, you know, once I find that hot brush pile with the crappie on it, mark that little waypoint there and try and hover around that thing. So we got everything wrapped up here with this boat so far. New lights on the tail lights, LEDs, waterproof. Hopefully we don't have to replace those anytime soon. Got everything serviced on the motor, and I am exceedingly happy that there was no water in that lower unit fluid. So that's good. Got the transom mount transducer on there. All we got left before I'm content with how things are on this boat is a trolling motor. So got to figure out a mount for that. My cousin's going to be working on that for me. And we'll mount a trolling motor on the bow. And if I'm ambitious enough, I might actually put another trolling motor here on the back on the transom, depending on where I'm fishing. So that's the game plan. I'm super happy with it. This boat has done extremely well for the times that we've taken it out, and I'm just looking forward to all the other stuff that goes on with this boat and the places it goes. So if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to leave me a thumbs up. If you guys have any suggestions on things you want to see me do to this boat, drop it down in the comments, and I will catch you guys on the next video.